Christmas jingle bells. Christ is born and the devil's in hell. Hearts, they shrink, pockets swell. Everybody know and nobody tell. Little wheel, spin and spin, big wheel, turn round, round. Little wheel, spin and spin, big wheel, turn around and around. Oh, the sins of Caesar's men, cry the pious citizens.
Been spinning for the last 4 years. I started by a friend telling me that there were two alpaca fleeces in a garage somewhere, and I knew of alpaca fleece because I'm a dressmaker and I love the fibre, and so I just couldn't resist. I had to have a go. So it took me 6 months to find a spinner to teach me. I said to my husband, this won't be costly, but it's kind of a few spinning wheels and a loom later. Spinning is a very relaxing thing to do. And I think most spinners sort of sit there, sort of just sort of mesmerised by the wheel in a way. Fellow spinners, there's a great sharing, I think, with that sort of craft. People seem to be so keen to share their expertise. It's not like guarding the secret. They sort of want to sort of give what's there, and then you find that you want to pass that on to other people. So you also share, you know, your things as well with them, which I think is a nice thing.
We use them, but you don't have to.
I've got a poodle, and I wanted somebody to spin the fur, because I don't know if you know, poodles have to be trimmed. Yeah. But no one would do it, and they said, well, you can learn to do it yourself. So that's why I got into spinning. I now spun his fur and made a pair of gloves with it. We all get together occasionally for meals and things like that. It's a very relaxing hobby.
And I found it by chance the other day.
I actually got into it downstairs with Pat Meaden, and she's a very good teacher, and she involves everybody so that everybody helps everybody else with, you know, any problems they've got. Because it's not, as you can imagine, the easiest thing. There's not only one particular material that you can spin. You can spin anything from recycled bottles, you know, the plastic bottles. They shred them and then we can spin that. And bamboo, wool, silk are the normal things. But, you know, anything that mats we can spin. Dog hair, anything.
I love the feel of it. It was very, what's the word? It's very calming. It's very, there's something too about doing what you know has been done for thousands of years. There seems a kind of connection. And there's also the feeling that you want to keep these old crafts alive. And it needs people like this group to keep that going. We very often have people, when we have an open day or an exhibition, we have people coming in saying, oh, I didn't know you were here. I'd love to come and join you. That's how we got a lot of our people downstairs. So it really needs to be practiced and shown to be practiced. So whenever we're invited, and sometimes when we're not, we go out and we demonstrate at different places. I used to be just a student here, you know, and then the teacher that we had to leave. And I was the idiot who said, if there's any dog spotting to be done, I don't mind doing it. And you should never say that, because you end up with the whole job. So I've been running the class for about 12 years now. We had, when the previous teacher left, we had about 19 students. Now we've got 32 altogether. And they've come together more as, much more than just a spinning group. They're very supportive of each other, which is good.
I've probably been spinning since about 99, because I went to the Falklands and was taught to spin by the ladies out there. We used to call it the Stitch and Bitch group in the Falklands, because everybody got together and, like typical women, I learned all about the sort of rumours and the history of people and what they got up to, because they could tell you all about everybody in the Falklands, because there's only 2,000 people to talk about. So part of the fun of spinning is the social side, and more difficult to tell a man what's going on, but there's an awful lot of female supportiveness amongst groups like this, in a variety of ways, because people know one another, and if anything happens, then people are willing there to at least give their sympathy, support, advice, which is nice. I got involved with the Guild because I found them at the New Forest Show doing all sorts of exciting things and being very friendly. So I turned up at the Guild with a great wheel that I wanted to find out how to use, and was told immediately that it was useless, but I was lent the Guild great wheel. So that got me started here. And in view of that, I've gone back and I'm now the treasurer of this Guild. But I feel I owe them a lot, because I enjoy the company and I enjoy the skills of some of the people. I mean, there's tremendous skills here, and there are probably skills that ought to be passed on, but it's very difficult to know how to pass on things that now there aren't even courses to help you with.